All right, wonderful people, lovers of freedom, good morning, good afternoon, good evening to each and every one of you. Welcome back to Let's Talk TV, your one number one YouTube platform, where they give you now back-to-back updates on how things they be, on how things they shelle. If you're joining us for the first time, remember to subscribe and turn on your notifications too. Yes, and also remember to like and share this news. Yes, because of course, you are not the only one that needs this particular information shared to your friends and loved ones. Okay, my people, as it is hot right now, what we are getting is that the PM, BRGIE, has done noble. He has sent a rescue mission to Germany, as he sent, he set to an increase times 10 momentum over MNK case. My people, that is the hottest we are getting at this particular point. It's done bust everywhere. As you all know, the zeal that the PM has for anything that concerns Biafra and the movement of Biafra. And I believe that is what he has done to make this certain move that he made recently concerning the Germany movement and they're sending people to for a rescue mission. My people, there is nothing that we cannot do so long as we know what we are able to stand for. And that is the truth of the matter. You see, the PM has sent a rescue mission to Germany. This is a powerful thing. Has sent a full-time direct message to them. As he sent this, has sent it over for pressure on the Mazen Nnamdi Kanu case, making sure that there is pressure from a whole lot of sides for it to make sure that things actually work out well. And that is the truth of the matter. That is nothing but the truth. Because if we are getting pressures from all sides, if we are getting pressures from all sides for something to actually work out, then the possibility or the probability for that particular mission to end up successful is close to, it's over 50%. If that's one thing I know it's over 50%. So if we are getting pressures from the Nigerian side, we have pressure from the Finland area. We are also having pressure also from the Germans. We have connected to other of our foreign alliances, the ones that are able to push. We have also, as you know, we have a link with the Prince Charles, the one that we said that was sick, and we need prayers for him to actually recover, because he will play a key role in everything that we are doing. If there is pressure from all these sides to make sure to push out, to compress this federal government that has been talk to the bone to make sure that we do not have what we need to make sure that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is actually released. Once there is pressure from all sides, then we'll be able to push out and make them do what we need them to do. And that is why most of the things we are doing now, people look at it and they're like, why are we doing this? Why are we doing that? Why are we doing this? Why are we opening a Biafra coin? Why are we doing this? Why are we doing Biafra currency? As country has not started, and we are doing this, we are doing that. It is all for the goal. It is all a mission for the goal. There is an end game to everything that is being put. And the fact that some people are so naive and they do not understand that we are playing a long game. And that is the truth. The fact that we are playing a long game to get what we want is something that people have not come to understand. The PM is playing a very long game so that when the time comes for everything to be looked at, then you would find out that, that means there was a reason why these particular things were done. There was a reason why these particular steps were taken in the beginning. You would find out that everything that was done, there was a reason for it. And there is a reason for everything we do. That means we cannot in any way lax. Everything we decide to do is part of the strategy. Everything that is we come out and say is part of the strategy. And we move and work with it. And that's why most times we do not know about anything until it is being said and said, this is the next thing. Oh, we are having a convention here. And then everybody will now find that out. Before we talk about a convention, or before a convention is even placed in a country, every single the plans have already been made for it to work out in that country. That means communications have run through, and that now makes both the permission for it and every single thing to work out well immediately without any holding back or anything to even stop it. So everything that is being done is for a reason, and the earlier we come to realize that and support the cause with all we can to make sure that wherever we are, wherever we find ourselves, no matter what we do, we will always end up doing what is right. We'll always end up making sure that the end game will always result to our most need, which is the release of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and also our freedom. And so issues that have been coming out ever since, he says that, however, unabated, resulting in the killing of about 45 persons in the area. However, the member in the Benue State House of Assembly, representing Ukum State constituency, Ezra Nyiyongo, said about 20 people lost their lives in the incident. The incident which took place in Gbage community of Ukum local government area, and also claimed the lives of a family of seven, left 30 persons with various degrees of injury, while scores have been declared missing. In the attack by the people who were working with the members of a militia group in the area, in its bid to eliminate another militia group, Daily Independent learned that most of those people that were killed were members of the two rival militia gang. However, while we gathered that about 12,000 farmers who were caught in the crossfire were among the dead, the people of Gbage and its environs have been displaced following the killings in the area. A top military brass in Operation OPWS, who would not want his name in print, confirmed the attack and the circumstances surrounding the incident. He said, "These are militia men killing themselves. Yes, we acknowledge that probably one or two people may have been caught in the crossfire, but the majority of the people that were killed are members of the militia gangs in the area. Currently, we are in Kwande and are trying to contain the situation in the area. And as you can see, calm has been restored to the area. We have been able to flush out the headsmen out of Kwande, and I can assure you, normalcy will be restored soon. But be that as it may, our troops are in the area, Ukum, to ensure that the attack does not affect innocent people." Meanwhile, the State Commissioner of Police, Emmanuel Adeshina, said more police officers have been deployed to the area to contain the situation. Speaking on the condition of anonymity, a traditional ruler in the area explained that the fight started on recently and following a disagreement between one rival gang and the other, who was backed by the headsmen over the weekend. He stated that what followed was that another militia gang in the Ukum now went and joined forces with the Fulani militia gang in Taraba to help them eliminate the rival gang in Ukum. The essence was to enable him be the head of the militia in Ukum. Okay, so he said the combined forces of the headsmen and militia gang started moving into the bushes of Gbega in their hundreds from Sunday to sack the other rival gang. From what we gathered, over 45 persons were lost, or rather, who were mainly bandits, were lost in the crossfires, and though some farmers were also lost who were caught in the crossfire, over 30 others were injured, while some are also missing. My people, these Fulani people are giving issues to a whole lot of people, not only people that are just wherever they are, but every single person. And these are not the people, and these are the people we wake up and we are saying that in Inowere or Igbo land or in Anambra, wherever it is, that we would wake up and give them a space or an opportunity in our land to stay and go and graze their fowls. Look at the amount of issues they are causing in their own place. Yes, in various states. So think about what these people will be able to do in our own state. Think about the mayhem they would cause, allowed into our land. Already, we already know that they have already been causing a whole lot of issues in our land. Now think about what they would do if we now give them that audacity to enter into our land and do whatever it is they seem that is right for them. My people, it means we are sentencing ourselves to death, which would be the worst thing we could ever do to ourselves. Also, yes, my people, this is it. This is where we've come to the end of this particular broadcast. Thank you for joining us. Remember to subscribe and turn on your notifications too. Thank you.